Hello guys and girls, Voices from the Dark here. Welcome back to the amazing saga of Herald Hellfury. In the last episode, we pretty much wiped out Swadia. The map is looking really, really red right now, and I like that. There's also some enemies around Rindiar, so I just kind of wanted to ride out and just check out what's up. Make sure nobody's doing any funny business around here. So Lord Despin is in here. He doesn't have the greatest force, but I count on him to grow his forces over time. Oh god, they hate me. Oh god, okay. Good thing I'm not that near them, so I won't have to really to deal with them a lot. That's good. Right, but when we have a big force like this, we need battles to actually keep ourselves sustained. Oh my god, the Nords are so powerful, man. Why did I make them so strong? Why? So we need to plan our next attack, but while I think of what to do from here, let's go up and let's slaughter some Sea Raiders. The Nords. The Nords are a very powerful kingdom. War with them is the least thing I want to do. I will be spread too thin if I try to go after the Nords. I know that if I could take the Nords' territory, I would pretty much win the game, but it's not worth it. It's too much of a risk. And so we have the Kurgites. The Kurgis are sort of spread all over the place. And so I almost feel like if I take their territory, I would also be spread all over the place. Now, Rodox is sort of the one I'm looking at the most, because they are sort of situated now in the southwest. And if I took them, they would, it would pretty much secure my back. It would, like, secure me from attacks from the south. Which would be very nice, because then I could sort of get the western side of Kelradia to myself. But I don't really want to be the one who provokes war right now. I have a feeling that I'm feeling pretty good just sort of running around and getting some troops trained. And rather, if I'm attacked, then they've just sort of decided for me. Because I think, at least, that you get more less reputation if it's better for you to be attacked, because then people won't think you're sort of, you know, a war starter. Yes, a war starter. Warmonger? Is that what it's called? There's a caravan here, so it's very easy for me to start war right now, and I do have a considerable kingdom, but neither of my lords have that many men, so we need to wait for them until they manage to gather up some troops. Should pretty much do the same. I'm running around with my A-team right now, though. I really want to run around with my A-team. I might go back and do a giant training spree, and I know training is not going to be the most exciting of things. I know that my castle is sort of situated all the way in the corner, but it does sort of secure our position, because if people want to get there, they have to sort of get by my other towers and places, so I'm okay with it being a little bit off. I can change it at any time, like, if I want to, I can move it over to Suno or Pravin or whatever, but I'm kind of fine with it being there. Or would I get more money from towns? Would I want to change it to Pravin? I'm not sure who's controlling Pravin. I think Nysar is controlling Pravin. Alright, we are back. Oh! Blue Nords. They're blue. No. Alright, I'm gonna be doing some switching. That Master Archer still lives. It's infuriating, but it's the truth. Everybody who's not top tier will be placed back. I'll probably have a lot of men-at-arms with me so I can ride faster. We have those Kurgit veteran horse archers. They're kind of cool. I'll try them out. That's what I'll do. I'll try them out. See if they fit me well. Maybe I'll have to get a size smaller or size bigger. Warriors, I don't know, they're not really that low tier. I'm thinking more people who really need the practice, like, let's say, like, lots of forest bandits and recruits and stuff. These people, because I want them to be bigger, because yes, when they're small, they can pretty much hold castles and stuff very well, because of their numbers, but I want somebody I can ride out to war with. I want somebody I can depend on. Oops, I don't know why I clicked that. I was supposed to click done. Okay. And again, what about these people? Should I just, like, release them all? That would mean that they would go into like hiding with another faction. Let's keep them all in my jail for now until I figure out what to do with them. Just stay down there. Alright. So let's go on a little training and recruiting spree. Recruiting some more Nord soldiers. And training in general. I'm glad I'm on good terms with the Nords. That's very important for me. Because if they declare, then we're gonna be losing castles. That's the thing. That is the thing. So we need to think about this. Let's see here. Let's check out this village. Getting some Nord recruits. Just riding around like this is good, because I think we have another guy with training now. So we are doing quite well, actually. Well, that's good to know. I could give more sort of castles to myself to increase like the money amount I make, but right now I just wanted more companions first. Okay. So we gotta go find some Sea Raiders. Let's go see if we can find that Sea Raider landing up here. It should be here. Well, we also loot and think about where to go from here. We've been so focused on the war with Swadia lately that now that there's peaceful times. But I don't think it's a bad thing that we take things a bit slow right now and sort of figure out what to do. Oh, the Nords, man. I don't know how I feel about them. I think I helped them out too much. I wasn't thinking about the long run. That I wasn't. River Chig. Sell off some of this. Buy myself some. Drive me to. My men are fine with their fruit and cabbages, aren't you, men? They're fine with it. Alright, any Sea Raiders here? I haven't seen any Sea Raiders. Oh, really? Just from recruiting, I'm getting ambushed? It's not very nice of you, but sure. Fire all your arrows into me and let's see what good it does you. And good oh, damn. Where did that come from? Hey, guy, not nice! I don't think I need a shield to fight this last guy, actually. I just need a good hit of my sword! Perfect. Don't try that next time. Ta-ta! One guy was watching the battle, he was like, yeah, pretty cool, I can join. I mean, just riding around like this is what's gonna make these people, oh, damn, here we go. Alright. Let's upgrade people. Get people ready for the battle, which is going to drain our money, but that's okay. Right now we have money to spare. Could potentially start up a new dye work somewhere. But I don't know who to start a war with yet, so maybe that's a bad idea. Ooh, that's perfect. Lots of bandits! Yes, now we have two Tundra bandits. So they have a lot of troops, but I do have some pretty elite guys in the front here. I have all of my followers and I have some men-at-arms that still need a bit of practice, so they're Tundra Bandits, they should be no problem. Hopefully not too many of my noobs will die in the battle, but I think it is a risk that is worth taking when it comes to the glory of Hellfury. Yeah. One. Ow, don't hit my horsey's head. Yeah. Let's try and keep these bandits busy so they won't like have time to snipe out some of my lower peasants. Hey guys, this is not cool. Yeah. Leave my peasants alone. Although I was the one who provoked you, but it's just because you're a very easy prey. That's the only reason. Your excellent practice and morale boost. When I have a big army, I'm gonna need these small fights to keep everybody happy. Like, the Hellfurians are very bloodthirsty. Like, if you don't have at least one man dead every day, they're like, I don't know how I feel about this. Let's charge in here. Hiya! Hiya! Off with your head. Hey! Oh, damn it, I was gonna do some sort of epic thing there. But I guess not. I'm taking a lot of damage here, but Rather me than my troops, I guess. But if I take too much, I'll retreat, of course, because they're Tundraband is, but they can still poke me full of holes and kill me. Yeah! It's so weird to think back on how we used to fear these Tundra Bandits as we rode around with Harald Hellfury. Back when he was just wearing a cap and still learning how to swing a sword. Come a long way. It's been an amazing journey, though. I really like that in this game, how you can sort of start off from just nothing and becoming this immensely powerful lord. Oh, I got him. There's more of them. Stop them! None survives or escapes, except for these guys, apparently. Yeah, I got him. And no, you don't. That wasn't a hit, apparently. Do you have him? I'll take him for you. Who's next? Who wants to assert next? Ah, they're running over the hill there. Oh my god. I have a spear through my stomach right now. Yeah, we took a lot of damage in that battle. We lost a few men too, but the experience of it all was just priceless. Just at the price of the less. Getting some top tier troops here too. That's good. Yeah, look at this. This is what I like to see. Skirmishers. Perfect. Dun 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 dun. Nice. Now that we've spread them thin a bit, we'll chase. Actually, I'll stop by here. Yeah, let me come. There we go. Surrender or die. Another battle. So these battles aren't awfully exciting, but it might as well fill our time with something while we train our troops. Because we have a lot of lords, but I don't know how many men each one of those lords fields. I take it that they will recruit and train troops themselves over time. But if we go on a campaign, then I should have sort of a backup force that I can give them. So I'll still have people in my castle protecting, and I'll have good people on my team, but I should also have some people I can give out to my enemies. My enemies? My companions, rather. That's just what I'm thinking, which means a lot of recruiting and then training those recruits. But luckily we have a very high trainer skill, so time kind of flies. I'm just so happy to have Metheld and the others back. It really, really makes this experience better. We just need to decide who to go to war with. And I'm so scared of like going to war with like Rodox and then the Nords attack and then suddenly I'm stuck with the war on two fronts and it can get potentially messy. I'm not gonna be able to defend against two factions at once. And I mean, I am becoming very quickly a dominant power in this world, which is why I really want to keep my relationships good with Ragnar and the others. But I'm not really sure how to do that. So I'm going to be treating the Nords as good as I can. Because my relationship with the Kingdom of Nords itself is actually very good. Even if Ragnar's relationship isn't too good. Alright, so now we have some people we can go and sell off. If we can find a ransom broker, of course. Spearmen. Why did I get spearmen? Sorry. It happens sometimes. It happens. Alright. Ta-da! And we are off to Kurov. It's a tournament here. I'll consider joining. I will consider it. We have plenty of food, which is good for our troops. Sure, let's join the tournament. We might as well. This should be a Vagir tournament, so it might be a bit. Oh, I thought I was having a pole arm. This is definitely not a pole arm. I thought that was a pole arm. This is a two-handed sword. I keep being knocked back by this guy. I can't do anything against him. Yeah, I really hate the Vagir parties. I've been eliminated. Well, I actually just skipped that entire tournament because it was nothing but me failing and failing at firing arrows, so yeah, that happened. Alright, let's be on our way. It's just a big reminder that I don't know how to use ranged weapons. Alright. Dun, 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 dun. Who's raiding Nords right now? Are Rodoks attacking the Nords? Maybe if I... Maybe if I helped out the Nords and fought Rodoks. Okay, so Rodoks is now focusing on Nords. That might have just sealed the deal. Let's see. Rodoks mistreated. Okay. I don't know, Serenid Sultanate. They're too far away from my kingdom to be a potential target. It's difficult, man. So all of the Rodoks are all riding up north. Whoa, they took Dirim from the Nords? Oh man. Oh, that's right next to my place. Oh god. Yeah, Rodoks is really getting big right now. I wonder if it was possible to enter any sort of like alliance. That would have been really good to be able to focus on just one guy. Wow. Alright, so Rodoks is really going at it, which does mean that they're a bit more spread than usual, I would assume. I don't have a lot of troops in my garrisons and stuff. That might be a problem, but... Rodoks might be the place we charge. It might be, because... Well, oh, Jay. Oh well, we're going at it. We're just going at it. Whatever. We would spend 5 episodes just getting all of the men ready for doing this, and I don't really have the time to do it off camera either, so we're just gonna have to sort of attack them. We're just gonna have to start the attack on a Rodoks, I think. There's been an episode of making decisions, and I think that's the result. Since Rodoks is now attacking the north, and I feel like they're a bit more spread out. It sucks that I got Dirim, though, because that's sort of in the middle, right next to several of my castles. It's a big shame. Nothing we can overcome. Nothing we can't overcome, rather. Alright, come on. Up here, horsey. All the bands are probably going to be dead by the time I arrive, huh? I can get a few kills. It's good. A few kills of the day. Keep my men happy. A few kills a day. Keep the abandonment rate away. He got knocked the F out. Alright. Yeah. Butcher got wounded. Of course he did. Alright, we gotta find a ransom broker for all of my Sea Raiders, I think. I'm starting to slowly get this, These people are slowly becoming better. Yeah. I'd say these people are starting to become ready for war. Not all of them, certainly, but... Hey, we've done some work here. It's not been half bad. So gotta stock up on even more food and probably ride out. Let's get a bunch of recruits. Maybe recruits should just fill up one castle entirely. Oh. Yeah, there's constant fights for Dirim. Constant fights. So I think we will should I really call upon my men and start a campaign? Not sure. It's not so long since I did one, though. I might start this off on my own. I don't know. People have their land to defend. That's something I must take into consideration. Okay, but let's go to the Lord's Hall and just see. Oh, there's so many people. Lady... Oh, look, sorry, I'm Harold Hellfury. Ooh, who are you, my lady? She was kind of cute, actually. Except for my, I already have such a good relationship with Lady Thera. I can't even see her right now. Look at all these people. Everybody wants to join the Hellfury Legion. It's no small wonder. An emissary to Ragnar. that I wish to express my goodwill. Who shall be your emissary? Rolf, sounds good. Seek recognition. So I think that means that I'm just like, hey, yo, guys, I like you. Let's see, what can we do? You may be aware that the quarrel between Lord Reymald and Gundyr is damaging the unity. Persuade the lords. Alright. Resolve a dispute. I can do that. Let's go talk to Reymald then. See what's up. I think I gave Reymald Herringoth. Apparently he's a little... He's a little being a little bit of a meanie pants. Or they're having a disagreement. Damn, we are making cash. Reymald, what's up, my man? I wish to address your quarrel. Lord Gundyr once ran an errand for me, and now he thinks I owe him something. I owe his ilk nothing. I want you to settle them. Defer to your judgment, I will try to make amends. Suppose you should speak to Lord Gundyr. Actually, where is Lord Gundyr? Since I should probably go and talk to him. Gundyr. Wait, where is... Do I even have somebody named Gundyr in my party? What? So, okay, let me check this out. Let me see the party size reports. We're doing quite well. Faction relations. Lords like me. Who is Gundyr, though? Where do I check that out? Maybe notes? Ah, here we go. Characters. Yeah, okay. So, is he just hanging around in the castle? Is that what he is doing? But how can you have a dispute with somebody who's not even joined us? I'm not sure. Let's go back and have a look. I don't really know how this works. Oh, Gundyr is right here. Oh, your service is not required. He renounces allegiance. Okay. Basically, the game thought I had Gundyr on my team. I didn't have Gundyr on my team, and now I can never have him. Okay. Thanks, Arden Manor. You're great. I should have just told Reymal that he was right all along, I guess. I can remember any Gundyr, but I think the game kind of derped there. I would say King Reynar wishes to be at peace with Harald Hellfury so as to pursue the war against Rodox. He merely refers to you as... Oh. He does not think I have a right to rule? Well, we'll show him. Later. Once I actually, no need to piss him off just yet. Alright, where could Reymald be? I gotta find him, though, and solve these silly disputes, not resputes. I ask again, may I have the honor of visiting your daughter, Lady Thera? You may have my blessing, as long as your intentions. Okay, thank you. Just ask you. I want to know... Where's Thera? She's at Herringoth Castle, eh? Well, I'll certainly hair up her castle. Ooh, rawr. I don't know what that means. You should not be inside for this attempt to visit Lady Thera. Alright. Thera, can we get married now? I have the money. I really want to get married with you, okay? Do you like poetry, m'lady? Ba-ba. It's very worth. Okay, so she liked it a little bit. Can we have a future together? Go ask him. Yes! 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 Yeah! Good. Alright, now we gotta go find Raymalds. Raymalds. Good old Ray Ray. Ray Ray. So if we get him, if we get her on our team, then our right to rule is gonna go up dramatically. Everybody's gonna be like, ooh, Harold Hope actually has a chick now. Hmm. He's a threat. But I feel like it's just a natural part of the progression, getting ourselves a wife. Let's get Rolf back up in the action here. He's sort of our talky guy. We send him all over the place just to talk. I love that we dominate the western part here. The Midwest, I suppose. I wish to marry your daughter. Alright. I shall plan to hold a great feast. We'll be sure to notify you. Okay, there we go. So, how's my money situation now? Not good, because, you know, marriage costs. So I'm gonna go and looking for Ransom Broker, then we're gonna be scouting out Rodox. We might not start any fights with them this episode, we might sort of just try to figure them out a bit first. We got lucky here. He's like turning around like, dude. Creepy guy. Bam, that got us, 1,500, I think? No, like, more like 2,000. Let's see. Now we got some veteran spearmen, which aren't, you know, amazing, but they'll have to make do. First of all, if I took Uk's call, I'm sort of considering whether I should pursue this direction and sort of get the middle of the land, or if I should just go down here. But I do want to see how Uk's call is looking. Arr, let's go chase out some bandits. Right. This place would fall in a matter of hours. Uk's call is definitely somewhere I can take, and I think it would cripple them a bit. They also have a castle down here. We need to lay a battle plan for a plan of attack right here, because I can also send up my lords to take over places if I know that they have enough. So I could possibly send them to take one place while I take the other, and that could be a tactical thing we can do. Could definitely be something we do. I need some better relations. Also a peasant castle. We could easily take this. Right, I'm getting more and more excited about the thought of attacking Rodox, since they're attacking Nords too. Can you move? Thank you. Maybe I don't like to wait for the wedding though before I go on like a crazy attack. This castle, on the other hand, has several more crossbows. That's kind of what I'm scared of, all of these castles up here with tons of crossbowmen. Because we have to, like, climb a mountain to get there with bolts flying all across our ears. Same here, like... oof. I don't know. I really don't know right now. Things are getting spooky. How's the morale? Morale is actually dropping off pretty quickly because I don't... because I have weight... like, my army is way too big at the moment. Oh, that's right. I can't accept anybody. Alright, so my prisoners are slowly escaping over time. It's okay. Prisoner tower? No. We'll manage to garrison them. We will send some of these people in, because I can't be having this big of a force. Actually, I should get my assault force out, I think. I think that would actually be for the best right now. Oh man, we are going to be starting another war. This is going to be very, very interesting. So, Rodox is now occupied with fighting the Nords, but I haven't seen any huge Rodoxian armies around. But who knows what they could be fielding in secret. I don't like the thought of that. I really don't. Let's get my best men on the team right now. It's my A team. I need more Rodox sharpshooters. I don't know if there's really any areas I can get them once I start a war with them, but they've never really been an essential part of my army. Gotta get you, of course. Alright, and I think I want a lot of these since I'm going to be sieging a lot of castles. Having some warriors up front is probably good. Then the rest knights, maybe? I think you can go with that strategy. Our speed is very good. Alright, I'm going to declare war. That's actually something I could just do from home, really. Maybe that is a more honorable way to do it. I do not know. But let's do it like this. I'm curious to see how this way works, because that means I don't have to like chase down peasants and declare war on them. Let's see. I wish to dispatch an emissary to Graveth. That I declare war. If you attack without provocation, your vassals may consider you to be too warlike. They're weak. I must strike while they're weak. Or spread out, rather, but they're focused somewhere else. It's a difficult decision to make. Maybe I should just have one more look, and I wonder if any of my guys are actually, oh god, my inventory! That's something I should have, considered a bit more. But we have to, don't we? I think we do. Alright, let's do it. Let's do it. Let's declare war against Rodox and let's go against them. There will be a lot of crossbow bolts flying all over the place, which are scary indeed, but it must be done. I should dispatch an emissary to Graveth and tell him that I declare war. Alright, so Lord Rayamald, he's the only guy who didn't like that too much, and that's actually okay. Because with this declaration of war... Yo, Nizar, can you do something for me? Let's see. How can I ask him to do something? Follow me. I like him on my team, at least. I really want to start a huge campaign. Am I seriously being attacked? Of course I am. At least have the decency to show yourself. So we're going to be attacking the first Rodokian city. That's going to be the final objective. From one war to another. We had a time of relative peace, but peace just doesn't suit me. We need the blood to run again. To fill the rivers. Oh, I just heard somebody. But where are the bandits at? Oh, there's one. Not that he's a problem. Anybody else? Three bandits jumping Warlord Harald Hellfury. Not good. But now people should be having to like recognize us as a true lord since we are now going to get married in a little while. Proven never has any food. Total nuisance. Okay, so let's go to Suno and buy then. It's on the way to where we are going anyways. Oh, I saw enemies incoming. I saw enemies incoming. Spy that. That's a start at least. Let's actually stay in Suno. Alright. Gotcha! He thinks he can go after Nizar. Ooh, Montawar is out here too. He's too close to Suno, too close for comfort. I gotta hunt him down. We have the same speed, but he ran into a tree and then it was over. Surrender or die. So the Rodokian War begins. Swadia fell beneath us, but then again we need to consider that Swadia had like four or five castles, two towns. These people have now three, four towns and more castles than I can count. I do think Rodox can be a tough war. This guy is feeling a lot of Kurgites, which is a total nuisance, but should be okay to fight. I feel like my sword arm is like slower lately. All my attacks seem a bit slower. I wonder why that is. Maybe that's just my imagination. I'm not 100% sure about that. Yeah. when I spend more points with Harald Helfrich, it's usually in charisma, just so I can feel more men, because it's such an essential part, but I would have loved to have more weapon masters. I can upgrade my one-handed skill even further. Able to get faster and deadlier hits. I love that Metheld is out here riding with me. No, you don't. I'm gonna cut you off. Fine, if... Oh, he ran away. His backups hadn't even arrived, and he still decided that, nah, you know what, I don't like how this battle's turning out. Our troops are spread pretty much all over the place. It's hard to really have a good strategy against these horse archers, at least I don't know of any strategies yet, so... Kind of sucks that we're going to be losing part of our besieging force right now, but it had to be done. I couldn't leave this force near Suno. Suno's not well defended at all, so it was essential that we attacked. And he was going to harass Nysar, because he didn't see me, I think, until I came out of the darkness. Yeah. There we go. Oh, I thought I killed him and the horse. That's the best. I think you can do that if you slice both the horse and the man when they're low enough. Oh, sorry, that was a horse. Instincts. Sorry, horsey. Never come charging towards me on the battlefield. Do not approve. Is that a Kurgit Lancer over there? Oh. No longer. Alright, can I... Out of my way, people. You. Take him out, man! Stop the Kurgit! Everybody focus all your... Oh, he got mauled. He got totally destroyed. Oh, that's awesome. That is really cool. Should be most of them taken out. Good work. Really? 170? Ugh. My battle advantage is like 118. Let's go crush some fools. Hey guys. Yeah. Still gonna take a while though, because they're Kurgits, so... We're not gonna be swarming some Swati militia here. Yeah. Gotta ride after them for centuries first. Oh man. Yeah, that's one. Where's the other one though? Oh, he was right next to me. I didn't even see him. Alright. Good work, man. That was such a glorious battle. I will take you prisoner. You'll be my first Rodakian prisoner. Mountain bandits to fill up my ranks. Some morale from that. Alright. Yaelin and Nook's Call. That's right! Wait, Yaelin? Haven't Yaelin usually been my town? Right, Yaelin is a Rodakian town. So, those are going to be sequestered, which means we're going to be losing money, which is why I need to take back at least Nook's Call, because I have men here. So, Nook's Call, that is where we shall ride. Wait, Dirim has been besieged by Lord Olaf? Are you- Oh, I don't- I'm sorry, Olaf, but I don't have that much faith in you, but sure, keep them occupied. I appreciate that. I'm just waiting for the text, Dirim is no longer under siege. Alright. I will come shortly. I'll probably come after this battle. If you know what I know. Wait, did he just leave me? I think he just left me. I think Nysar just ran off, did he? He did! Oh, maybe his kingdom was under attack then. Okay, then... Oh, come on, Mithil. That means this is going to be more difficult than I had anticipated. Wow. Okay, any archers? Stand over there. Are we inside the walls already? Cool. Mithil got knocked unconscious pretty early. She was probably hurt from the last battle though. So I don't blame her too much. It's a struggle getting past those. They're actually real obstacles. This is again one of the battles where I wasn't up first, and that means I'm gonna have to standing around here, which is why it would be good to have a bow and arrow, but that would remove two of my shields, one of them being my back shield, and As you've seen, I'm quite fond of my shields because it allows me to just go into combat and just fight as I want to. These poor guys. So Huskarl's round shields. Nice. Wonder if I can get that on my back. I'm not sure. I don't think so with one of the shields I have. So we're just gonna wait. So the situation right now is that we need to take Ook's call, because we need to get our dye works back for our money. And then we'll see what happens with Dirim. I don't think Lord Olaf can take Dirim. It would be nice if he could, of course. And then I guess we just need to prepare to attack Rodox. Just sweep south and take out their main places. Like the Helfurian Plague upon the land. That is how we shall fight. It's indeed how we shall fight. Up the ladder! Here we go, come on, man. I think they actually outnumber us a bit, I can't remember. They have like twice as many forces right now, so that's not very good. Luckily, we have some of the Nords up front here, and the Nords are just making things. Oh! The Nords were making things, oh god, he's just rolling down the ladder, poor guy. Alright, here we go. We're almost up. We have a lot of soldiers here. Hopefully they won't all get slaughtered. Come on! We can do this. We have this Are you serious?! Oh my, okay, screw that then, I'm standing down here. Have fun doing whatever you want to do. Alright, looks a bit more clear now. I'll try and move up. This guy hanging off the wall here. Yeah, I think we managed to take out the main bulk. That's good. You got that side. Look at all these shields. It's just a giant slaughter right here. Alright, man, good work. Sure, I'll go with the men. See what they're up to. Reinforcements, where do they spawn? We're there, I think. Why are all my Nords falling off? Careful! Guys! Oh no. Yeah! Alright, here they are then. Let's take them out. A lot of Rodakian crossbowmen. We will fight them! Till the end! Yeah! 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 Bring it on! Scum! I just feel like I should have a presence on the battlefield in this battle to help out the odds. This war is just starting and I need to, like, save as many of my men's lives as I can. I need as many troops as possible. Yeah! And he went off. So all Rodakians shall fall. Let him be a message to the rest of you. Here! Bye-bye. No! Stop that, you're not being very nice. All Rodakians must fall! Bye-bye. The fall of Rodox, literally. Here! Coming soon to cinema near you. Rated R. Stop hitting me with the axe in the face. Not very pleasant. This is just a mess. These poor archers were not like, they didn't think they would be getting into close quarters, but at least since I'm keeping all of them busy, most of them won't even pull out their crossbows and snipe, which is where they're strongest. Although I fell down just now. Let's charge. Actually everybody charge. Some of them are just standing down there. Not sure what they're doing, really. But yeah, I should get my archers up on the walls. I don't know why I still have them situated down there. That's probably not a very good idea. Yeah. Decided to trade blows with him there. Because, well, I have armor and he does not. Yeah. Alright, this should be the last bulk of them. Down with Swadia. I mean, Rodox. It's just become a habit to say Swadia by this point. Rodax shall fall, just like they did. Just like they did. Now, after this, I will go and see my lady. Haha, I think I will take Ux's call for myself. Alright. Take you, my prisoner. I saved, Ooh, Tansu guy, he's my guy. Alright, so he likes me more now, that's perfect. I didn't know he had been captured. Okay, so let's upgrade our men and then, ooh, that was a lot of upgrades from that, that's good. Let's take the best of the best. Kurgit Lancers, they are a top tier unit, so I will take them. No, there's not a lot of good things to choose between here. Veteran horse archers. I'll take some peasant women, just because I can. I don't really want to take too many of those guys. Take some Swadian footmen, and I suppose we can take veteran footmen. And who shall be the last guy? I don't know. Manhunter. Just for fun. Take as much of this as we can. We have taken Nook's call. Let's see. I want it for myself. Oh yeah. Okay. Good, good, good. So I can now move my court over here. Which I might consider, because it's more, it's situated better. But I just want to see if the city will stand a bit before I do that. Because I think I need to get some ingredient, like some, things before I can move it. Tavern keeper. Ransom broker. We'll sell off my guys. Also, I think one of my men can level. And now my morale has become excellent again after that wonderful, wonderful battle. Let's see. I want to tell me about your skills. Pathfinding and spotting. That is amazing. I love Borcha. Like, we need Borcha on our team. He may not be the best in combat, but what he brings to the table is very impressive. Alright, so here's Ux's call. Actually, oh, damn it! Why did I do that? I was supposed to, like, not give it to somebody first. But then I guess I would have to go all the way back in order to give it to myself. So, that's okay. We should just take this castle while we're up here. That's what we should do. Okay, let's manage the garrison of this town. Put in a few people here. It's not a lot of troops. I need some troops to properly fill up this garrison. But I do like that we have Ux's call. Okay. We are going back to Teverin. I'm leaving this sort of open for attack when I think about it. I'm leaving it too open for attack. I'll leave everybody but my knights so I can ride home, be protected, but still get there in a reasonable amount of time. This is more difficult to take. Alright, let's ride now. More speed and security. Everybody, all of the lords are coming to my place. Okay. Okay, here we go. Manage. Because I need to take a lot of people out. First of all of my best stuff needs to be confiscated. Eager knights and all the horsemen and stuff. A Swadian footman too. I feel like Teverin Castle is a castle that's... It's not at risk of being taken. Because of its positioning. So I wouldn't worry too much about the troops that it has, but... I'll give it some. I think it's actually fine. I'll throw them in the dungeons. Okay, 12 recruits right there. Okay, so I need to go and see my lady. She should be at Herringoth, I suppose. That's where Raymeld rules. So let's go to Herringoth. My lady. Okay. You wanted to see me. I'm still waiting for that that marriage, though. How wonderful. Now, I think I saw your father over here. I might want to go and talk to him. Maybe I should just get a lot of recruits and keep them all situated in my castle. Actually full so quickly. Alright. But money. That's something we are running short on. You told me I should reject. So I will listen to that. My honor rating is pretty okay. I'll just have to find some other way to get myself the money. How's the weekly? We'll barely make it. Alright, back at Ook's call here. So we can manage our garrison. Place some of these men inside. Get ourselves those knights. Horse archers. Just because I don't like them that much. You know. Okay. So now I need to go and take the other castle in the area. This episode might also go on for quite some time, but let's get some of those Kurgit Lannisters out here. Serenade Master Archer, I'm still waiting for you to die! So, whenever you feel like it. I think all my hired blades are dead. Yeah. Alright. Since we now have Ook's Call, that should actually help our monthly, yeah. I think a lot of our villagers have been raided, though. Wait, where are you? Somebody was... There's some Rodakians in this area. But we will take this castle first. Now that we've taken so much, now comes the question of being able to protect it well. My hope is that Swadia will stay in a war with the Nords. And we have a lot of different lords running about, so we're just gonna have to try our best. I love it when there's two ladders. Let's get our way up here. Yumi Matheld, come on. We got this. Chop them down. Yeah. Gotta just chop out their heads a little bit before I try to enter. I think this is a new castle model. I can't remember seeing this, actually. Yeah. There we go. We are inside. Yeah. Take them out! Gotta make it so that my men can actually make it up here alive. Did I just get knocked out? Whoa. Okay, you guys are actually kind of fearsome. I'll give you that. I'll give you that much. Damn it. It's hard when there's two of them. Shit, I'm gonna die. All of the tryhard is going on right now. Okay. Hide in a corner. Hide in a corner. They're sniping me from up there, though. I think this is one of the safest places I could be right now. Let's get all of my archers up here so they can protect me while I stand in this corner. Oh my god. So yeah, I am a bit reckless when I siege, but that's mostly just for the fun factor and like the excitement factor of it. Go take them out, man. That's good. It's really good. So if we can establish ourselves a little bit right now, that would be excellent. Good. I have some archer backup here now. It should protect me against any reinforcement waves. That's good. Clutter the staircase and I should be just fine. Protect your master. You don't have to stand behind me, dude. That's not gonna help you much. There we go. Try and fire some shots in where you can. I know it's not easy. It's a cluster right now. I'm not blaming you for just standing still. But you can feel free to open fire though. I don't really know if they can open fire so close. Just do your thing. I think they just want to go in close quarters. I'm not gonna stop them. I got this guy at least. As long as they're in front of me and like helping me a bit, I'm fine. Fight, fight. There's like some poor guy stuck in the middle of all of this. Reinforcements too, actually. Wow. Yeah, we got a couple of troops coming up. Who's left? I'm being very careful when I'm moving about here. Rodox could snipe me. There's somebody down there. Oh, here some people are. Take them out! Yes. So the castle was ours. Good work, men. Oh, we took a lot of casualties here. Took a lot of casualties. So I might just have to hire everybody to really get back on track again. Yeah, let's actually hire a lot of people. Because I can get these people in my garrison at least, you know? Lord veterans. Knights. Think I will also give this castle to myself for the money, basically. Right. I want to decide that later, because that means I get free troops. Look at this place, it's so fancy. Yeah, there are my free troops at. You looters, you will now become mountain bandits. So now this castle is ours. Look at this. This is looking really good. So where are we vulnerable now? They don't really have any big towns that are threatening us. Their big towns are sort of on the coast here, so I feel pretty safe actually. Lord Olaf's attack failed, but not surprised. I'm glad he tried at least. It kept him a bit busy. So who should get this place? Let's see. Reports. Of my lords, Olaf, Tansugai, Reyamald. I think Monty War is one of the guys who are just not really happy with me right now. I might give this castle to him. Yeah, I might give that to Monty War. I would like to move my court though. Maybe I should move my court to Suno, where it would be closer. Closer, basically. Wait, they just sieged. They wait for me to leave and then they siege? Despicable. Okay, let's see if we can scare them off then. Hope they don't have too much of a grand force over here. Rolf, you can level up. You are our tactics guy. You are a smart guy. More tactics, allowing us to deploy more troops than the enemy ever will. And trainer, because it's getting more and more important to be good at that. Okay. He has a lot of troops. First of all, he has a lot of prisoners, so we could get some Huskarls even if we defeat him. He has a decent amount of crossbows, like 100. And then he has like a variety of peasants. His main force, though. I don't know if we can take him. He's attacking our castle, though. I think we're gonna have to make that decision in the next episode. We've been going on for way too long. Have a still good day, take care, and stay awesome. But most importantly, everybody, stay dark. Goodbye.